let's take a deeper dive into the render settings of After Effects, create and manage the templates. So to demonstrate how to work with those render templates, I'm going to use this composition, which is part of the Energy Pulse tutorial. There's a link in the description if you want to see how I made it. And I'm just going to play it for you so you'll see what we're going to render. But of course, you can use any composition and follow along. So to generate an output, you can either render your compositions using the render queue or add them to the Adobe Media Encoder queue with the render settings that you have chosen in the render queue panel. But the primary way of rendering and exporting movies from After Effects is, of course, through the render queue panel. So to add this composition to the render queue panel, I'll make sure it is selected, and then I'll go to the composition menu and select add to render queue. There is a keyboard shortcut here on the Mac. It's Command Control M. On the Windows side, it's Control M. And by the way, just so you'll know, you can also go to the file menu, choose export, and you have the same command over here. In both cases, this is going to open up the render queue by default in another tab near your composition. So I'm going to grab this and I'm just going to drag it over here to the main composition panel. And this way we can open up the settings and we can take a look at them with more real estate room to work. So as you can see, by default, it is set to not yet specified. You can click on this and give it an address. I'm just going to save it on the desktop, and this now becomes a queued item. And you can add as many render items to the render queue, and After Effects is going to render them in a batch unattended. And this will happen when you click on the render button in the upper right corner of the render queue panel. Now, we're going to see it happening in a moment, but I just want to call your attention to the fact that you can right click on the comp name from the render queue. You can duplicate it. You can duplicate it with a different file name. You can add an output model, which you can also do by pressing on this little plus over here. Or, this is the coolest thing, you can reveal the composition in the project. So if you want to take a look at it and return back to working and maybe modifying your settings. But we are ready to render, so I'll return to the render queue panel and I'm going to open up the options near the render settings and the output module. And as we can see, there is a summary here, which is going to tell us what is going to happen when we are using this best settings, which is the default settings when you are choosing something to render inside After Effects. The same is true for the output module. So first, let's concentrate over here with the render settings. If I want to modify this template, and by the way, if I'll click over here, you can see that I have few to choose from. We have two ways to work. One way is to go to the edit menu and choose templates and then render settings. You can do the same for the output module. Another way to work is to click on this point down arrow and choose make template from this list. And this is going to open up the render setting templates. Now, it will create a template by default. As you can see, it is already set to untitled one. I didn't want to do it, so I'm just going to delete this, because what I think you should do as well is just organize it and maybe define better defaults. So first, from this pop-up list, I'll select the DV settings, which is a very old settings that I think nobody is using anymore, at least not me. So to make the list a little bit shorter and more easy to manage, I'm just going to delete these settings. I just want to show you, if I'll select best settings, this is a summary of everything that we are going to select. And maybe I want to change these best settings, because as you can see, by default, it is set to use no proxies. So instead of modifying this one, I can duplicate this, and then I'm just going to add a dash and write down with proxies. Then I'm going to click on edit, change proxy use to use all proxies, because this is my preferred way of working, and then click OK. And now I can change the defaults here. So I'm going to change from best settings here to the thing that I just created, best settings with proxies. For the frame default, I'll change it to best settings. And I highly recommend that you will do it too, because this means that every time that you are exporting a single frame, After Effects is going to render it in full resolution. The pre-render option, as far as I know, is something that you can't use anymore inside After Effects. So this is a leftover from previous versions that will allow you to save a pre-rendered cached file. So I'm just going to skip to movie proxy default, change it to best settings, and I'm going to leave the still proxy default as is. So basically everything here should be at least best settings, or if you modified something that you created over here. Now, I just want to call your attention to the fact that you can save and load those presets. So this means that if you want to move them to another machine, you can click on Save All, navigate to wherever you want to save. I'm going to do it on the desktop. And this is going to save an After Effects render settings or .ars file. Let's click Save. And finally, let's click OK. Now, to make it work, we need to actually delete the render and add it to the render queue. I'm going to do it in a moment because I want to show you now how to modify the output module. These settings will apply to each render items and determine how the rendered movie is processed for final output. You can use those settings to specify file format, output color profile, compression options, and other encoding options for final output. You can also use this to crop, stretch, or shrink a rendered movie. Doing this after rendering is often useful when you are generating multiple kinds of output from a single composition. But I think that this pop-up menu is filled with stuff that we don't really need anymore. So again, I'm going to choose Make Template, which is going to allow me to define the defaults as well as change those settings. I don't want to create anything new here. So again, I'm just going to delete this untitled one. And let's start by cleaning the stuff that we don't really need to use anymore, at least to my opinion. I'm going to click on this pop-up menu and select lossless. This used to be the default inside After Effects, and it still is for some reason for pre-rendered movie as well as a proxy file. Again, this is something that you can't really use anymore, so we might as well say goodbye to it. Why? Because it is using a very old codec inside the QuickTime wrapper, which is the animation codec, an 8-bit per channel codec, which is going to create huge files. And by the way, if you're working on the PC side, this is probably going to render an uncompressed AVI, which is again something that you may or may not need. I'm going to vote no. You don't need it. I'm going to show you what you should use. So I'm going to try to delete it, but After Effects is not going to let me do it because this is now used as a template. So I need to change the pre-render default to something else. And my recommendation is to go with high quality for both of these guys. And this is going to use the QuickTime codec, but this time, just to show you a quick summary, it is using the Apple ProRes 422. And if you need an alpha channel, then you have a high quality with alpha, the Apple ProRes 4444. But now I'm going to return to the lossless option. I'll delete it from the list. I'll do the same for the lossless with alpha. We don't need it anymore. And I'm also going to modify the TIFF sequence with alpha. And this is again a personal choice. I'm not using TIFF. I'm actually more of a PNG guy. So I'll rename it to PNG sequence with alpha, then click edit, and then choose the appropriate codec, which is the PNG sequence. Everything else is set automatically over here, so I don't need to modify it. And now if I need to, I can change my default settings. So these days, the default suggestion from After Effects is H.264, an MP4 file, which is heavily compressed. I rather use the high quality as my movie default. And again, for the frame default, I'm going to change it to a PNG sequence. Again, this is my personal preferences. The save current preview default doesn't matter. Again, we can't use this one as well as pre-render default, as far as I know. So it's up to you what you want to do with them. Now, as before, we can click on save all, give this file a name, And this is going to save it as an After Effects output model file. And this way I can load it in another machine. Now in the next tutorial, I'm going to show you a better way to work, which is how to sync those settings with the Creative Cloud account that you have. So watch for this tutorial coming very soon. But now I'm just going to click OK, and I'm going to select this render task and delete it. I'll return back to the composition panel, go to the composition menu, add this item to the render queue, just to show you that After Effects is going to respect my new defaults. And just because I don't want to leave you with nothing being rendered here, I'm going to click on this little plus to add another output module. This one is going to be a 5 megabits per second MP4 file. And maybe I'm going to add another one. And this is just for the sake of demonstration. Let's go with this one, 40 megabits per second. Now, to help me understand what I'm rendering here, I'm going to use one of the built-in tokens. So near the word output 2 in this down pointing arrow, I'll click on it and I'll select comp and output module name. I'll do it for the other two options over here. And if you name your output module in a logical manner, then you'll know exactly what those files are without even opening them. Now, just to show you why I'm working like this, I'm going to actually render this. And this is just to show you that After Effects is going to render it only once, and it's going to spit out three different files. So let's open up one of them, click on this hyperlink. This is going to show us the three files that we've created. So this one is the 5 megabits per second. You can see the size of it. This is the 40 megabits per second. And this is the default, or my new default high quality movie, which is a ProRes file. And this is it for this one. In the next tutorial, I'll show you how you can sync these templates along with your preferences, keyboard shortcuts, and more, so you can carry them to another machine. Until then, I want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you again very soon.